Wednesday night, the United States Air Force carried out a crucial test of the Minuteman III intercontinental ballistic missile (ICBM) conducted by the Air Force Global Strike Command. The test involved an unarmed ICBM equipped with sensors to gather data on its launch, flight, and landing performance. According to reports, airmen from the 625th Strategic Operations Squadron at Offutt Air Force Base in Nevada launched the missile using a launch control system aboard a U.S. Navy E-6B Mercury aircraft. The missile was randomly selected from a group of Minuteman III missiles based at Minot Air Force Base in North Dakota. It was then transported to Vandenberg Space Force Base in California, where it was reassembled in preparation for the test. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the test firing of Minuteman III ICBM from the E-6B Mercury is a potent capability demonstration. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Boeing E-6 Mercury aircraft is a crucial asset in the United States' strategic military operations, especially in the testing and launching of nuclear missiles. Operated by the U.S. Navy, the E-6 Mercury is designed as a command and control platform for global military conflict scenarios, enabling communication and control over strategic nuclear forces, including the launch of ICBMs. The E-6 Mercury is a modified Boeing 707, tailored specifically to manage nuclear forces and uphold strategic command. Its core mission is to maintain secure communication between U.S. strategic nuclear forces, including nuclear missile submarines and land-based missile systems, and the command centers of the Air Force and National Military Agency. Importantly, the aircraft has an endurance of 10 hours 30 minutes unrefueled, 28 hours 54 minutes with one refueling, and 72 hours maximum with multiple refuelings. With its Take Charge and Move Out, or TCAMO, missile control system, the E-6 Mercury can issue launch commands to strategic nuclear assets, even if land-based communication is compromised. The aircraft is equipped with advanced communication technology, allowing constant contact with strategic platforms like Minuteman III missiles even during global conflicts. The TCAMO systems aboard the E-6 Mercury are capable of assuming control and executing missile launch missions if other communication channels are disabled, making it a key component of U.S. strategic nuclear defense. The Minuteman family of missiles has served as the backbone of the U.S. land-based nuclear strategic force since 1962. The Minuteman III began development in 1964 and entered service in 1970. America deployed around 1,000 Minuteman III by the end of the 1970s. The number shrunk to about 450 by September 2017, and currently there are about 400. Minuteman III is designed to be launched from missile silos, and they're primarily based in three locations: Minot Air Force Base in North Dakota, Malmstrom Air Force Base in Montana, and F.E. Warren Air Force Base in Wyoming. The U.S. military plans to keep the missile in service until at least 2030, till the LG-35A Sentinel becomes operational. Minuteman series of missiles gained range with incremental versions, with Minuteman III acknowledged to have an operational range of 8,100 miles, or 13,000 kilometers, though the exact range is classified. The original inertial navigation system provided it with an accuracy of about 200 meters circular error probable, or CEP, but an updated inertial guidance system gives it 120 meters CEP. This basically means the missile can be targeted with near pinpoint accuracy, even at long distances. Minuteman III was the first true MIRV-capable missile. It can carry a maximum of 3 warheads, and these can be independently targeted against 3 different locations. It carries a W-78 or W-87 warhead. The W-78 thermonuclear warhead is the warhead used on most of the United States Minuteman III missiles. The W-78 has a publicly announced yield of 335 to 350 kilotons of TNT. The W-87 is an improvement on the W-78. Its design includes all modern safety features. The original yield of the W-87 was 300 kilotons of TNT, but has the announced ability to be upgraded to a yield of 475 kilotons. So a single missile is capable of unleashing destructive power of around 1,000 to 1,400 kilotons of TNT. To give viewers a perspective, the Little Boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima had a yield of 15 kilotons of TNT, and the Fat Man atomic bomb that was detonated over Nagasaki had a yield of 21 kilotons of TNT. Over the past decade, the U.S. has conducted more than 300 successful test launches of the Minuteman III ICBM. These tests are part of a routine program aimed at verifying the missile's reliability, accuracy, and readiness as a critical element of U.S. nuclear deterrence strategy. While there have been a few failures, most of these tests have been unsuccessful. Despite its age, the Minuteman III is expected to remain in service until at least 2030, having been refurbished and modernized to extend its life. So, the ability to launch the missile from E-6 Mercury is very important, specifically in a situation where an adversary conducts a large-scale preemptive nuclear strike with an aim to disable command structure and communication lines. The capability ensures that even in a global conflict with disrupted communications, the U.S. military retains control over its nuclear forces, including missiles like the Minuteman III. General Thomas Bussière, commander of Global Strike Command, explained this precisely. "These tests demonstrate what our airmen bring to the fight when called upon by the President. Airborne launches validate the viability of our ICBMs, which are the cornerstone of our nation's defense and the protection of our allies and partners."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.